Hello everyone, I am Alligator and welcome to a bit of a different video. In this video I'm gonna show you how to make a sort of one wide triple piston extender. Now before I get to that, I'm gonna show you this one. I'm pretty sure everyone knows this. I can't remember who made this version. Now it is very small and compact. But for most users where I needed a triple piston extender, at least for me, it has proven that this was a bit bulky. It was a tiny, tiny bit too big. But of course, it's still very good. It works very fast. Of course, these green wool, or just there to show where they're gonna, the block the extender is supposed to land. This one is a just normal double piston extender. Now why am I showing you a double piston extender? Well, it's because you see how small it is. And it's also very good as it also works. Of course it works. So that moves on to the one I made. Here you might recognize this top part because it's the exact same as this one. Now why I thought, I think I can use this one to make a triple piston extender. And I was almost right. It almost worked. There was just one small problem with it, which, if I get rid of this one, just an observer, and then also get rid of this one, I will show you the exact problem I face. Oops. When I press the button, you see it extended, of course. But you see, this is also gap here. But that's not really the big problem. What happened was that it would retract everything except this one. Now this one is needed for it to work. So then I needed to add a little top. Bottom part and it works. Now of course it still have the block gap, which you can just do that, and it just need two inputs to actually work. But chances are that you do not want to have to press a button twice for every use. So that's why this little slug here, timed so perfectly that this is the fastest it can be. And it all works. But as you see, the whole mechanism itself, apart from all of this crimson stripped wood, it is just one block wide. This whole thing is one block wide. This delay you can add however you want. But I thought I will show some different examples on how you can do it to make it maybe better. First of all, these five repeaters are like three ticks. Of course, you will most likely want it to be to know how few repeaters there are, which is what this one here. Exact same layout, but now reduced to how few repeaters. How many repeaters you need at least, which is 4. Where 3 are on 4 ticks and 1 is on 3 ticks. Pressing this, as see, still works. This one is just to show you can make it kind of like this, but it's a tiny bit longer, but it isn't as wide. But why did I to make it like this. This one has obviously 5 repeaters with 4 ticks, but that's just to show. If I do like this, it is also a bit server friendly. Servers usually might not like it being this fast, depending on how good they are. So then you can also make it a tiny bit slower to give it time to maybe not break on the servers. But it is also a tiny bit too big for my liking. So this is my favorite version. It is a 2-block wide. It is as long as these ones over here. But it's a lot smaller. And as you see right here, it works as fast as you can make it. Of course, this one is still very good. There are many uses this one has, where this, well, mainly one use this one has, where this one does not. Being, it has nothing over it. You can place anything over this. This one requires to be at least this high. Otherwise it will not work. But that's where that one is better. But I can think that this one is also a bit wider. Meaning for me, this one is better in that regard. Where you can just simply place this practically anywhere with this version because it's so small. Now I can just stand here and you can from this whole picture copy the entire thing and make it work. But for those who don't want to, I will show you how to make it. Now to make it you need 5 sticker pistons, 6 observers, 2 droppers or dispensers, but I will use droppers, and a single block of your choice. And then also a resin dust, but that is generally not really needed unless you want to do the extra part, which is add this other circuit to make it only need 1 button push. Now that extra circuit only need 4 repeaters and a few resin dust, but that isn't really needed because the circuit back here you can do however you want. You can make it bigger, maybe smaller, depending. I think this is as small as I can make it, but it's all up to you. So that isn't really needed. It just changes however you want to. So starting with making this, need three sticker pistons on a row, 2 under, making this sort of shape on it, and then an observer which is facing up into this sticker piston. I will use a sea lantern as a block it will push, and then on top of it placing 2 observers right on top like this. The block just in front of them, and that makes the double piston extension. 1 dropper back here with red dust on it. Now it might be good to add those before the observers. But for most users you want these to be a dot. Now to make a dot you just simply right click it. Now, to activate it, you just need to... Oops. You basically just need to power the single block. The single dust. And it works like this. To fix it, just need two observers facing down, one server across into a dropper. And this is the whole system. This is it. It works as soon as you give it two inputs. Very simple. But now I will take that away as I am gonna show you how to make this version with the timing. The version with the timing, in my opinion, this version at least, is my favorite. So I will show you how to do it. It's also the most compact of them all. But of course, if you don't have space to make it like this, you can run around as much as you want, as soon as it's at least four repeaters. So doing that, same thing here is the input instead. And when it goes into the input, it needs to snake around a bit. Making a bit of this pattern. Like that. Repeater out, redstone dust under here. I usually like to have them on dots because then they do not power anything around them. Like this block will not be powered if I were to place a let's say sticky piston here, it will not be powered by that. But as shown by me. Oh yeah. That kinda, it does not get power by that, but I think it gets bad power by this. Because now if I take a resin lamp, because piston was not the best choice to use. But yeah, it just does not get power. So running, making a ladder. Like this. This one I believe must need to be a dot. Running straight into it like this. Now I'm gonna reset this a bit wider. It's because it needs to run up, powering this redstone dust again. Running two dust and then a repeater into a block. Now stopping here, I can add a delay with all of these three. I'm gonna be 4 ticks and this one 3 ticks. This is the fastest you can make this triple piston extender. You can make it slower by adding more repeaters, but you cannot make it faster. Now I need glass or a slab. Does not matter, I don't think, but I'm using glass. Just place two glass like that, resin dust running up like this, and that's now it's done. Taking resetting those, I can now press the button, as you see. Yeah, worked a lot different than I thought it would. Well, why do I even say that? Because it usually have time to retract. I don't know why it doesn't do it for here. It keeps the button pressed down. Yeah, that's the fastest you can make it, anyway. And that's it for this video. Now, if you like, I hope this video was helpful for you. So, thank you guys so much for watching this video, or following along, whatever. If you liked it, press that like button and subscribe. And I will see you in my next video. See ya later, alligator.